I'm going to demonstrate a spinning circular cylinder and how that can create lift. So as the cylinder rotates, and all I've got here is just a Bic pen. I've taken out the pen cartridge on the inside and taken off the end caps so that it's hopefully balanced left to right. And as the cylinder rotates, the surface of the cylinder, due to the boundary layer, is going to grab air in front of the cylinder and throw it down behind the cylinder. And that's very similar to how an aircraft wing works. It's basically changing the direction of the air, you know, as the flow comes into the cylinder or to the wing. It exits at a slightly different angle, and that basically what it's doing is pushing the air down, and the equal and opposite force that it gets from that is keeping the aircraft in the sky. So this cylinder will do the same thing. I'm going to spin it and move it forward at a really high rate so that it, due to that spinning motion, it will act, it will actually create circulation and therefore create lift. So what I'm gonna do is put it on the counter, and I'm gonna push down with my fingers on this really hard, and then slowly rotate it back until it flips out underneath my fingers. And that will give it some rotational speed and also some forward momentum. And I'll do that away here. You won't be able to see me very well, but you should be able to see it as it flies away here. It might take me a couple tries to get a good one. So hopefully you could see that cylinder lift into the air just slightly as it went down. It never touched the counter again once it left from my fingertips. Try to get a little higher this time. Okay, you get the idea. Basically, that cylinder will lift into the air due to the forward velocity. It needs both forward velocity and rotation in order to create that circulation. Remember that lift is actually proportional to circulation and forward velocity. So it needs both of those, but when it has both of those, then it can actually be enough to lift the cylinder into the air.